Hello and welcome to AirsoftTech.dk. In this episode, I will be looking at some of the math that goes into calculating what MOSFET to use and how much power it needs to dissipate. So to do math, we need, of course, a pen and some paper. In the past, I have been using the IRL7833. MOSFET. It has some characteristics. It can handle up to 30 volts. It has an internal resistance of 3.8 milliohms. It can dissipate 140 watts of power. Because this is milliohms and this is just ohms. Airsoft motors have some characteristics. Draw peak values around 75 amps, and I will be showing you this value in another video later on. In average, it draws 15 to 25 amps. For now, you can just take my word for it. The peak values is right when the motor starts spinning. When the motor starts spinning, we can draw up a curve at time zero. When we press trigger, what happens is that immediately we get some very, very high current spike when the motor starts turning, and that spike quickly drops down. The current will then fluctuate a little bit, and then at some point in time we get a shot, and just when we get the shot out of the BB, coming out of the barrel, the spring releases and there is no tension on the motor and the current drops almost to zero, sometimes even below zero. Then the motor starts spinning up, going down, and then we have the same cycle again until a new shot occurs. And then we have the same behavior, and for each shot we have a little bit less of a spike until we reach a point where the cycle just repeats itself over and over and over for each shot. Initial peak value will be roughly 40 to 75 amps. And you take the average value of all the values in this area, you will hit an average that will be around 15 to 25 amps. Have the values from our MOSFET. So now what we want to know is how many watts does the MOSFET have to handle. The MOSFET has an internal value, let's round this up to say 4 milliohms. To calculate this, we use a formula saying resistance times current squared equals the power. And let's round it up to say 4, because MOSFETs almost never gets to the absolute minimum value. So it's okay to just round up. Times the current of the peak, which is 75 amps of current. If I calculate correctly, 22.5 watts of power. The average value is, let's say, 25 amps to be safe, because these values will of course depend on what airsoft gun you use. So if we use the value of 25, it's the same calculation, 0.004 times 25, whoops, sorry, it's of course squared, 25 squared amps, and that is 2.5 watts of power that we will have to use in the MOSFET. So the MOSFET alone will dissipate this amount of power. And power equals heat in the MOSFET. So the MOSFET will need to dissipate this amount of energy. The peak value is just initially, so it's a very, very short amount of time that we need to handle this much. And we're talking maybe nanoseconds here. So the most correct thing to do in this situation will be to take the average power and assume that we have to handle that amount of power. What we do then is we go and look at our MOSFET datasheet, and for the IRL 7833 we have another value that is listed in the datasheet, and that is the junction to ambient temperature, and that value is listed for my MOSFET at 62 degrees Celsius per watt. And what this means is that this MOSFET will rise 62 degrees for each watt it has to dissipate, roughly. To estimate how hot the MOSFET will be, we can take the average heat and say the average wattage it has to dissipate is 2.5 watts of power times 62 degrees Celsius per watt, and that equates to 155 degrees Celsius. So that's very hot. As I just showed you on my curve here, in average it will dissipate this much. But we also have periods where we have very low values, and each time you stop shooting, you will have a cooldown period where you are not touching the trigger and the heat can be dissipated. But if you just pull the trigger and continue shooting, the MOSFET will get very, very, very hot. One thing that you can do is add a heatsink, which is basically a piece of metal that you attach to the MOSFET that will then dissipate some of the heat. I have found a heatsink where the specification says it has a rating of 18 degrees Celsius per watt. And that means that when this heatsink is used, the heat dissipated will, instead of being 62 degrees, be 18 degrees per watt. Using that instead, you can say that the average will be 2.5 watts times 18 degrees Celsius per watt, and that is 18 degrees Celsius. This is hot to the touch, but still acceptable. So with a heatsink, we should have no problems running the guns continuously for hours and hours and hours. It will not be the MOSFET that gives up. If we do not have a MOSFET, we have to have some other way of getting the heat away. One thing is that we can add some thick wires that will do anyways to the MOSFET and have that dissipate some of the energy. Another thing that we also do is often when we make the MOSFET, it looks kind of like this, where you have a hole up here and you have the three legs typically here. So what we usually do is that we remove the leg here so that there's a bit more spacing between these two, and we use this up here to add the wire. So when we have the incoming wire and the outgoing wire down here, we add a huge fat connector here with a screw on it that we bolt through it. As you have probably seen in my other videos, this screw, this connection here, and this whole plate here will help dissipate the heat and transfer it to the wire, so that the wire will heat up as well and take some of the heat. And the same will happen at the source. The wire is connected all the way up here, and we add a big fat lump of solder so that all of this area will be used, and of course the wire as well will be used to remove the heat from the MOSFET. And that of course helps a lot, so that we will not get to 155 degrees. We will perhaps lower the junction to ambient temperature to a little bit. Say perhaps we will get down to maybe 50 and get the total value down to 100-120 degrees Celsius, and the MOSFET can handle being 100 degrees. But the best thing of course will be to add the heatsink. And with the heatsink on, you will have no problem whatsoever.